These London plane trees are easily about 150 years old at least. I've seen a picture from 1957, way before these flats were built, and these trees looked the same then. I decided to grow some London plane trees. Different sources say if they're easier not to grow, but I thought I'd give it a go. Now, to get them to grow, you've got to pull seeds directly from the tree, it says. So now I've got to jump up and get some seeds directly from the tree. Please excuse me for showing off my belly. The reason why you got to pull them directly from the tree, I don't know, because there were plenty on the ground, but where I looked up, you've got to pull them directly from the tree. And it says you're supposed to do this in November, but I did this in March. Now, these are actually clusters of seeds. Think of it a bit like a dandelion. You know when you blow a dandelion and all the little seeds float off, and you're just left with the stem? That's what's going on here. Now, these did have a tendency to float, so I had to support them into this cup of water with a peg just to keep them down as much as possible. I don't think the microphone really picked up the sound, but it almost sounded as if they were drinking the water. You could hear them drinking the water, and then little bits of air popping up every now and again, but it was a very strange sound. Anyway, after the 2 days, I was left with this mucky looking sort of water, and I started to separate the seeds from the centre. And the centre of it reminded me a bit of like the hazelnut out of a Ferrero Rocher. You can see here that the seeds have separated from the centre, whereas before they were quite firmly stuck on. You're not to tear them off because that'll just break the seeds, but they're easily now just separating from the middle here. I wasn't too sure which soil to grow them in. And I've got a range here. I've got some soil that I got from B&Q, and I've also got this mud that's left over what the Venus flytrap was in. Now, that Venus flytrap lived for just over 2 years, and the London plane tree is a hybrid itself. I think it'd be amazing if I managed to crossbreed a London hybrid with a Venus flytrap. It'd be almost like Little Shop of Horrors, wouldn't it? Well, anyway, I start to separate the seeds in different ways because I wasn't too sure how many of these seeds were actually gonna take. So in the ice cube tray, I put in as few as possible that I could separate. In the egg tray, I just put in big clumps. And then in the soil with the Venus flytrap roots in and whatnot that were left, I just put big clumps in there as well. And I also got a cup, and I put a big clump of the seeds in there as well. This mud that I'm using from B&Q, I suppose I should say compost, shouldn't I? Oh yes, adding some compost to this ice cube tray. Whatever. It's mud. It's worm poo. It's got John Innes in it. And I don't know who John Innes is. I've not bothered to look that up. Is he dead and been ground up into this mud? I don't know. Is he a worm? I don't know. Anyway, it's supposed to help the seeds grow, so I thought that'd be the best thing to use. I'm adding as few seeds possible to these ice cube trays. This egg tray thing came with a fridge, and we don't put our eggs in the fridge in the UK, we don't need to. And in this, I am putting big clumps of seeds in. Now, I think the centre of these reminds me of Ferrero Rocher. If you've watched this far into the video, I think you can tell that I am not some kind of professional gardener here, but if anyone can grow these London plane trees, I'm sure I can. I reused this mud, moldy, sort of mossy sort of mud, because I thought that it would be full of nutrients for the seeds. I was wondering how this would work with the London plane tree. We've got a lot of experimentation going on here. And I just plop it all in together. I do put a bit of the John Innes mud from B&Q on top of it, just to make it look a bit more tidy. After around 10 days, look, I've got little trees growing! How cute! I'm so pleased they've grown. Now, as you can see, they've not all taken. I've just got little dribs and drabs of them growing here. After another week and a half to 2 weeks, I've decided to replant them because I wanted to see what I was going to get out of these. Now, unfortunately, the ones that were growing in the egg thing died off, which was unfortunate. But I found out that the ones that had covered over to add humidity are the ones that survived. Now, I'm going to transplant these over into a bigger pot now, and obviously I'm going to keep them covered. Why am I growing London plane trees, and why are they so popular? Well, I thought I'd give it a go because they're so popular, and I thought maybe they'd be easy to grow, despite some sources saying they're not very easy to get going, but once they grow, they grow. A reason why they're so popular in built-up areas is because they're incredibly low maintenance, they're really resistant to storms, they are really resistant as well to even vandalism. Because if people spray paint the bark of these trees, it doesn't matter because the bark peels off. And also as well, that means that pollution that sticks to other trees, that isn't really an issue with London plane trees. That's why they always have that mottled sort of greeny greyish sort of look. They're really, really good trees to grow in built up areas because they're incredibly resistant to modern urban life, whereas other trees may be also susceptible to disease. London plane trees just grow. They really don't mind what's thrown at them, really. These trees are resistant to disease and pollution and vandalism. They're great, but what's the negatives? Well, unfortunately, in some parts of the world, they've been banned from being grown. Which is a bit ridiculous. The tiniest bit of maintenance would stop that, but some councils are just too lazy. The problem is, as the trees get older, they can cause a bit of damage because of the roots growing underneath pavements and raising them, making bumpy pathways, or even growing into buildings where they have actually been really allowed to grow out of control. You know, they do need a little bit of maintenance, but in over 160 years, the tiniest bit about of maintenance. Also, they can have a bit of a dust issue because the peeling bark obviously turns into dust in the summertime. And in the winter time, well, autumn time, you've got the leaves falling as well because they are deciduous trees. I'm replanting the little baby trees here into this little window box thing. And it was a bit faffy and a bit fiddly because they were very, very delicate. But I wasn't too sure that if I kept them in this ice cube tray any longer, that they would end up like the ones in the egg tray. I thought it'd be a good idea to replant them into this box. The lollipop sticks are just to raise the boxes that I'm going to put on top because obviously I'm going to keep the humidity up. And I'm not going to waste the dead seeds because I'm thinking that maybe they might come back to life, and I've repotted them into that cup. tea tree. Cup of tea. Cup of tree. Whatever. If you want a cup of tea, go make one. I'm not making one for you. Anyway, that's it for this video. I hope you've enjoyed watching part one, and we'll see what happens in part two. I did make a bit of a mess though, so I had to over everything up. Yeah, thanks for watching everyone. Please scress if you found this video tremendous to watch. You may want to scress because you'll then see part two.